For countless individuals across the globe, personal grooming, specifically shaving, has turned into a part of their everyday routine. Whether it's men removing facial hair, women shaving their legs, or anyone attending to specific parts of their body with waxing, plucking, and laser treatments, our peculiar relationship with body hair cannot be understated. It's rather bizarre to think about how many hours we spend throughout our lives removing hair that inevitably grows back. Unfortunately, societal norms often dictate the standards of smoothness we pursue in maintaining our appearance. The question naturally arises, how and when did shaving originate, and why does this practice still persist today? While we can't pinpoint an exact moment for the advent of shaving, artifacts and expert inferences suggest that our ancestors engaged in body hair removal as far back as 100,000 BC. Stone Age men would actually pluck their hair one at a time, sometimes even employing rocks or shells for expediency. Fast forward 70,000 years later, and the human race started using sharpened flint to shave hair off their bodies, proving the utility of flint beyond simply starting fires. However, the true story of shaving unfolded with the Egyptians. The belief was prevalent among them that body hair signified uncleanliness, prompting both genders to rid their bodies completely of hair. For hair removal, they used primitive depilatory creams and shaving lotions made with potent ingredients such as quicklime and arsenic. The advent of early razors coincides with the metalsmithing and mining developments that were underway around the world. The Egyptians' obsession with cleanliness was such that the upper classes would bathe multiple times per day, shave their heads bald, and wear cooling wigs in public to counter the heat. The fear of uncleanliness, attracting pests, and unpleasant body odor in the hot climate were the Egyptians' strong motivations to adopt shaving. Consequently, shaving began to be associated with class and status, a sentiment that persists in certain societies to this day. Having an unshaven face could reflect negatively upon your financial capacity or indicate a lackadaisical attitude concerning social standing and appearance. The habit of shaving didn't spread globally until the Greeks and Romans adopted it in the 4th century BC, an evangelist of the practice being none other than Alexander the Great himself. The motive beyond cleanliness was also tactical. Less hair meant less to grip for enemy combatants, thus making Greek warriors harder to defeat. Over the next millennium, shaving spread to Europe, the Middle East, and Asia, with different cultures adopting varied practices, from maintaining beards to keeping their faces and heads impeccably smooth. Major new shaving developments have been scant. The introduction of the hoe-style razor and disposable razors in the 19th century did make the process more convenient and independent of barbers. Today, there has been a resurgence of long beards and a burgeoning trend of body hair among both men and women. The norms for shaving differ significantly between genders and continue to remain a widely debated topic. Cultural norms and gender dynamics influence shaving habits in significant ways. Women's shaving habits, in particular, have evolved over thousands of years, often impacted by patriarchal societal pressure. Today, with gender equality becoming more pronounced, women are reclaiming control of their bodies and resisting pressure to conform to stereotypical beauty standards. Clearly, shaving has been an integral part of human culture since prehistoric times, serving various purposes from health to class distinction, gender differentiation, and idealization of beauty. How society's relationship with body hair continues to change in the future will indeed be an interesting trend to observe.